Hello everyone, welcome to NewsClick. In this episode of the Daily Roundup, we discuss some of the most important stories that we report about at NewsClick. चिट फंड स्कैम, जिसे हम एक कॉर्पोरेट घोटाला के नाम से जानते हैं, उसमें कुछ बड़े नामों का खुलासा हुआ है। इस घोटाले में जमा की हुई धनराशि 50,000 करोड़ तक की है। The money was not invested by big corporates. It was the hard-earned money of the poor people of this country. The government agencies, which should have fought for the interests of the people, are now being exposed for vested political interests. The two BJP leaders are being named in the Ponzi scheme. It is yet to be seen how the scam unfolds further. Those who are affected by the scam are trying their best to make this an election agenda ahead of the 2019 polls. Thousands of Devdasis from across Karnataka demonstrated at Bellary district, highlighting the plight of their struggle. The Devdasi system is a practice where young girls are married off to deities. When they attain puberty, their virginity is sold to the highest bidder, as dictated by the Devdasi system. The younger ones face the worst form of exploitation, as they are forced to become sex slaves. Mostly women from the Dalit and the oppressed communities become the victims of this worst kind of exploitative practice. The agitation of the Devdasis is gaining momentum. The first kind of a protest was held on January 19th under the banner of the Karnataka State Devdasi Women Liberation Forum, which has been leading the struggle for the rights of the Devdasis in the state since 2006. In the recently concluded conference, they reiterated their 12-point demand charter, which includes the effective abolition of the Devdasi system in the state and the payment of Rs. 5,000 per month as a pension to all Devdasi women. Meghalaya miners ki kahani hum sabko malum hai. पर झारखंड का धनबाद एक हॉटबेड के रूप में उभर कर आ रहा है जहां पे सबसे ज्यादा माइनिंग एक्सीडेंट्स हो रहे हैं। On Wednesday, an illegal coal mine in Dhanbad district of Jharkhand collapsed, trapping several workers, and rescue operations are still on. However, dead bodies have now been recovered. The outsourced mine of ECL in the area have become safe zones for local coal mafias. Private contractors ke saath saath coal mafia aas-paas ke gareeb logon ko, specially yuvaon ko, mining ke kaam mein lagwa dete hain. Beat Meghalaya aur Dhanbad. The number of accidents and deaths related to mining have been continuously increasing, as the poor are forced to work in abysmal conditions with promises of higher wages. More often than not, they are threatened by powerful men running the mafias. Thailand's military has caved into popular pressure and has gone ahead to announce the general election on March the 24th. This was the sixth postponement since 2015 when the said election was originally promised. This was also the fifth postponement since the adoption of the new constitution in 2017. The present government of Prime Minister Prayut Chan-o-cha is propped up by the military-controlled National Council for Peace and Order. There were severe protests that were being organized across Thailand in the month of January, which has led the people's victory and the announcement of the general election. That's all that we have for you today on this episode of the Daily Roundup. Follow our stories on our website www.newsclick.in, subscribe to our channel on YouTube, and follow us on Facebook. Thank you for watching.